All right, so as you can see at the time of this video, there's 2 days and 22 hours and 55 minutes left until Operation First Strike ends. And with its departure comes a new operation, which is what I'm gonna talk about in this video. So if you're not aware, Treyarch does these blogs and they announce all sorts of upcoming events in the blogs. So let me read this to you word for word. Here's what it says. As you've seen with some of the information that we've already begun to share, we're dropping our biggest game update yet next week with Operation Absolute Zero, a massive new series of content and the next phase in our commitment to making Black Ops 4 the most frequently updated and best supported game in our studio's history. So as I mentioned, as the Operation First Strike ends, this Operation Absolute Zero will begin. So then it goes on to elaborate on Absolute Zero. It says, Operation Absolute Zero introduces our first new post-launch specialist, Zero, a versatile and deadly hacker available in both multiplayer and Blackout. In multiplayer, Zero can disrupt and distract her enemies using the powerful hacking tools at her disposal, bringing new counteractive measures to the table in Black Ops 4. So we'll talk about that in just a second. There's one more sentence here. It says, players can unlock Zero by completing Tier 1 in the newly revamped Black Market and immediately start testing out her wonderful new toys. So apparently, it sounds like everyone's going to be able to get Zero for free. I mean, you have to complete one tier and that's it. Anyone can do that. So that should be good. So just looking at her, she reminds me of Outrider from Black Ops 3. But it says she can disrupt and distract her enemies using the powerful hacking tools at her disposal. So what does this mean? They've been teasing this on Twitter. I don't know if you guys follow the Treyarch or Call of Duty Twitters, but they showed basically what looked like either an EMP grenade or a scrambler. Do you guys remember the scrambler from what was that, Black Ops 1? Or maybe Modern Warfare 3? It's a little hazy. I know Black Ops 1 for sure had a scrambler, if I'm recalling correctly. But I'd love to have an EMP grenade. The problem is, what could you EMP? I mean, nobody runs half the score streaks that would be EMPable, like the sentry gun. You rarely see that, as it is. I guess if it worked like the Black Ops 3 EMP, then it would disrupt your specialist as well. And there's nothing worse than getting your specialist item, getting EMP'd, and then not being able to use it. But who knows how it's gonna work. Now, alternatively, it could be like the Black Hat. Do you guys remember the Black Hat from Black Ops 3? In the beta of Black Ops 3, that thing was incredibly overpowered. Not only could you hack equipment, like say someone put down an explosive mine, you could hack that and turn it into yours, but you could also do the same to score streaks. So if someone put up a UAV, you could hack the UAV and turn it into your own, which is absolutely incredible. That would be so cool to have in this game, but from the teasers, it looked like some kind of grenade. So I'm banking on an EMP grenade, but if that's her ability, what would be her specialist item? And hopefully it's not like the system hack from Advanced Warfare. That thing, when it first came out, that thing was super cooper annoying. That thing was ridiculously overpowered. A big skull would come on your screen and you couldn't do jack squat. It was terrible, absolutely terrible. But then they toned it down a bit and it was manageable. So I don't know, she could have a big system hack, which would be like the EMP grenade. Not the EMP grenade, but the EMP score streak, which would destroy like all score streaks on the screen. I don't know. This is an interesting character. And it sounds like the one that could be super annoying in this game. But still, a new specialist already? It's not even, well, I guess it is December. It's not even Christmas yet, and we're getting a new specialist. I will take that for what it's worth. Now, the blog goes on to state the following. 3 new earnable multiplayer weapons make their debut in Operation Absolute Zero via contraband tiers in the Black Market. Now, I don't know how to pronounce this one. It looks like demon, but it's spelled Damon. So, I don't know. But we'll call it the Demon. The Demon 3XB SMG, the SWAT RFT Assault Rifle, and the Secret Santa Melee Weapon, along with new weapon camos, reactive camos, and reticles to unlock along the way. And then it says, players can also immediately get their hands on these new weapons in Blackjack's Gun Game, one of our featured multiplayer playlists starting next week on PS4 and through Blackout Weapon Drops. So 3 new weapons in the contraband in this new operation. So what does this mean? You can probably pretty much guarantee that these 3 weapons will be towards the end of the tiers. Now, it doesn't say how many tiers it's going to have, but people are saying it's only 100 this time, as opposed to the 200 that we had with the first operation, which was First Strike. So if it is only 100, the weapons are probably going to be from 50 on plus. And you know one of them is going to be tier 100. You absolutely know it. So the question remains, what happens if, say, this next operation ends and you don't get the weapons? Let's say you didn't play enough to unlock the weapons. What does that mean? Will you never get it? I guess we're going to see shortly, because in Operation First Strike, as you can see here, I don't have tier 200 yet. I'm only tier 129, so I will not get this ICR Mastercraft variant. But as we've seen, well, right here you can see in the contraband, they have released some of the exclusive items that came with some of the bundles you could buy. So are they going to do the same for the ones in the contraband? Will we see this ICR in this little slot right here where you can just purchase it by itself? I don't know, because I'm going to be super disappointed if I can't unlock this ever again, if this was my only opportunity. But that begs the question, if they put it by itself, is it worth $15 to $20? Or maybe they'll put it in Blackjack's shop here for, again, an outrageous $15 to $20 probably. Is it worth it? I mean, you could grind it for free, and I guess that's what they're trying to get across. Look, here, guys, you can get it for free, or you could shell out some money for it. I am excited to see these new weapons. Of course, the melee weapon is just Mickey Mouse bull squash. Nobody cares about melee. Maybe people that only use melee weapons, I guess, could get excited about that. But it's a Santa weapon? A secret Santa weapon? What is that? I don't know. But the SMG and the assault rifle, that'll bring some good change. Hopefully they're not too overpowered, but hopefully they're usable. I want a medium balance with these two weapons. Nothing extreme and nothing terrible that nobody's ever going to use. Okay, so that's the extent of multiplayer. Now let's talk about Blackout. It says, on December 10th, we're setting the stage with several hotly anticipated updates to the core Blackout experience. And this includes armor repair, audio improvements, SDM and Spitfire weapon balancing, which means they're going to get nerfed into oblivion, and seasonal changes across the entire map. It says players will immediately notice the map's new visual updates as soon as they jump out of the helicopter. From seasonal changes in foliage and softer winter lighting to new smoke trails to better indicate where everyone is dropping. Subtle environmental improvements are also coming to Nuketown Island, Hydro Dam, and Factory. See if you can spot what's new on Monday and watch for our patch notes with more details. Then it says on December 11th, Hijack debuts on PS4 as our newest Blackout destination, located on the peaceful waters of the map's northwest quadrant. Inspired by the classic Treyarch multiplayer map, our favorite luxury yacht becomes everyone's new favorite hot drop in Blackout. And then it says they're announcing a new armored vehicle called the ARAV. It says light up your foes with its turret-mounted machine gun. Players can also drop in as Zero, the new specialist, after unlocking her, or as one of the four zombie-killing gladiators after finding and completing the brand new set of Blackout zombie character missions. Now this is the part I'm excited for. It says they're also amping up their collection of personalization items that can be used in Blackout. Right now, Blackout is dull as all get out. You can't use camos. It's just very bland. It's a nice change of pace from multiplayer, but it's bland. So it says here, there's new unlockable Blackout characters, new epic specialist outfits, shared war paints, and more personalization items to use in the world of Blackout. And it goes on to say that players will also find new weapons throughout Blackout starting December 11th on PS4. Try dropping into firing range next week to get your hands on the new hardware before anyone else does. And then they leave a note at the end saying even more is coming to Blackout soon with custom games, weapon camos. I guess they're not including camos in this update. That sucks. I was excited for that. They said stash interface updates on console, holiday map decorations, throwable snowballs, whoop-de-doo, Basil. New seasonal special event tiers, in-game promos, gameplay improvements, and more. Now, I don't really cover zombies, but they also mention a whole spew of things coming to zombies. I'll link this article in the description if you guys want to read it yourselves. But there's one more thing I want to cover here. At the end, it says the black market is getting a new update for Operation Absolute Zero. It claims it's going to make tier progression simpler and more rewarding. So it says starting December 11th, we're going to add the ability to mix and match war paints with different outfits, as well as gain access to war paints without having to own the corresponding outfit. So people have been complaining about this, because if you unlock a war paint without the outfit, you couldn't use it. So this is just a minor change, something that should have been in the game to begin with. But they're throwing it on us here December 11th. Oh, so I'm reading on here, and it does say 100 clearly defined tiers. It says they're going to reduce it from 200 to 100, so I was wrong earlier. It will be 100, 100% guaranteed. Then it says they're also basically mucking up the supply pool by adding new gestures, calling cards, and new decals. Everyone wants those decals to clog up the item pool. That's exactly what we don't want, but they're adding that. And then I gotta mention this real quick. This is for zombies. I said I wasn't gonna cover this, but they're apparently getting the daily tier skip. I was under the impression that everyone already had that. The fact that they excluded zombies from that is mind-boggling. I don't know. That's everything. We're getting three new weapons. One's a melee. We're getting all sorts of new personalization things in this operation, and we're getting the new specialist character, along with a huge amount of updates to Blackout. So I'm excited for this. I'm still curious how everything's gonna play out, especially with some of the weapons from the current Operation First Strike. Will these be purchasable in the Blackjack shop or in the Contraband under the Ultra section? I don't know. I'm pretty excited about these changes, but we'll see how they implement these. So far, the first Operation First Strike wasn't up to my standards. I was not a fan of how they did everything and some of the items in it. It's just, I don't know. I wasn't a fan. So hopefully this next one, they get right and everyone's happy, but we'll see. Let me know in the comments if you're excited for these new weapons. I'm super hyped for the Specialist. Can't wait to try Zero.